Hey guys, we're here at Sam Finelli's household. He has a half pipe in his backyard that he no longer utilizes. We're gonna take it apart, use what we can of it, take it to the warehouse.
Yeah guys, so we brought the bus to Sam's house. We got Garrett with us. Sam and Chase are helping us out. Finally moving his half pipe into the back of the shop, getting a ramp back there again so we can start doing jams and ride days and all of that kind of stuff. Yeah, here we are. We're about to get this torn up and then get it back to the store. Hey man, what you doing out here?
You know, breaking down a ramp to put it in the warehouse. Yeah, bomber bike there, man.
Tripod, I got a skateboard.
You ready to put this thing in the shop?
Yeah.
How long you had this thing? You built it what, during COVID?
Yep. April.
Yeah, Sam and his dad built this thing during COVID 2020. Came and rode it a couple times. And now it's gonna live on in the shop. Alright, so we're making some decent progress. Sam's getting the top off there. We're trying to get this one panel off. We got the one off on this side. And the wood actually looks pretty good underneath. So Chase went to go get another drill battery. We're still trying to get, Pythel got this whole back section off this side. The top of the wood there was pretty rusted, but we got a bunch of these 2x4s. Those are still good. And all the skate light over there and stuff is still good. So should be able to make pretty good use out of all this wood. All right, so we got a lot of hidden screws in here. There's a little bit of water damage. You guys could probably tell at the bottom here. This wood still should be good, but this wood on top, it's giving out a little bit. It's a little soft down here at the bottom. So we're just kind of trying to pry it off, get that top layer off, and hopefully the layer underneath will still be good. Sam said it's working a lot better over on this side. We're making progress though, slowly but surely. Get the rest of the 2x4s off, and then probably start loading into the bus. Pythel's got some stuff over there. Here, let me take you over there real quick. Here's some 2x4s and the sheet right there. Pythel's got all this nice skate light that's still intact over here.
Yeah, we just carried all the skate light over here. We're definitely 100% taking all this. And now I'm gonna go around, check all the panels that we've removed so far, and I'm gonna see what we're gonna take with us and what's gonna get left behind to be taken to the dump.
And we're gonna need all that skate light, and then yeah, we're gonna go through these ones over here. This is the top layer. Some of it's good, some of it's not, so we're just gonna have to see, but we're getting there. Making some more progress on this side. Got this piece down. Right now what they're doing is taking all the screws out of all the side pieces. So we kind of just take the panels off. The bottom's rotten out anyway, like right here. You can see where it's rotten out on both sides over there too. So we're just gonna take all these out. Slowly but surely, we're getting there. This type of project is way harder than it looks. You gotta watch out for these holes too. Got all the 2x4s over here. Pythel's throwing some more over there now. Boys out here working hard.
So there's a pile of the 2x4s that still need screws removed from the sides so they don't rip or tear anything up. That pile there is this, all the wood that's, all the screws are removed. Everything's fully ready to go, cleaned up, ready to be loaded onto the bus. So we got this last load of the 2x4s. Now we'll pretty much just take all this that's nice and neat up here, ready to go, load it onto the bus, call it a day.
All right, so we gotta get all this wood through here out to the bus out here. Sam and Pytel are already starting up. These guys are gonna grab some wood. We cleared out the back of the bus, put this little ramp here. We're just gonna fill this thing up with all the half pipe wood and then probably continue this project another day as the sun's starting to set a little bit. It's getting a little late, it took a little bit longer than we wanted, but it's coming along good and we're almost done, so. All right, we got all the wood out of the backyard. Most of it's in the front. They're loading in some in the bus right now. Here's all the, what's it called again? Skate lit. These guys are getting all the wood in here.
Yeah, push it in.
They're working hard. They got a piece of skate lit in there too. A lot of wood for one small ramp. Just gotta get these last pieces in and then get her to the shop. Sam's got a time lapse going here too. We got some stuff for TikTok and Instagram as well. If you guys are interested, follow those below. Working very hard to get this thing put together so we can get a ramp back in the shop so we can keep making content for y'all. All right, we got everything packed up in the back. Got Garrett and Patel back there. Now time to head back to the shop. All right, so we made it back to the shop. We got the bus halfway in. Let's go see what it looks like back here. Squeeze through. Got the bus back in here. Got Patel and Garrett here waiting on Sam and Chase to get back. Time to unload all this wood and get the halfpipe back right here. So it looks a little bit messy now, but give us a few days, we're gonna make it look beautiful again. All right, we got everything out of the bus. Hytel's in there fixing it up right now, cleaning up. Sam and Chase showed up. Got everything put over here. We got all the screws and stuff brought back with us. Here's a skate light, a couple sheets of plywood. We got the framing there, all the 2x4s. Sam's filming for the other social media. But yeah, so now we got everything in the shop. I think this is probably where I'm gonna leave you guys, and we'll bring you back when we start building it up in a day or two. See y'all then.
Hey guys, it is now Thursday. We're out here at the wonderful Newport Skate Park. This is one of the best ramps that a lot of us have ever ridden. The last time we built ramps in the half pipe, we stole the transition from here. I know how to build a ramp, but I don't know how to design transition. And all the videos you'll see online about like having a string with a point, all this and that, it never rides that good. We got a big piece of cardboard. And the best way that I've ever done this is I'm just literally gonna trace with a Sharpie the transition. And then we're gonna cut this out, trace what we trace here onto the plywood for the new ramp that we're building, so. All right, so we got these two pieces. I'm just gonna trace it, but later we gotta make sure to reconnect these. This Sharpie's dead. Good thing I brought two. So I'm just making some notes real quick later. This piece right here, the flat end of it, is flush and level to the ground. So later, I'll know that wherever that line is gonna be level to the ground. So now I can continue this line through and we'll be good to trace it later. Now we have our level ground, so we'll know that that's right there. When we get to trace it out, I'll line that up with this, right where these lines are on both sides. That's our half pipe.
All right, Pytel, what are we doing now?
We're getting some 3/4 ply.
Four.
Two sheets. It's gonna be for the side of the half pipe. Sam, all the 2x4s were treated and they're all good. We'll be able to cut them to length, but the sides were completely rotted. So we need new side panels. So I'm gonna get the two pieces. We just traced the transition at Newport. We're gonna take that trace and we're gonna translate it onto plywood, cut it out with a jigsaw, and then we're good to go start building this frame. So many player hating niggas trying to sound like that.
out. This is the scariest part, because if I mess this up, we gotta buy a whole new piece of wood, but I'm gonna cut out the transition. So with a full 4x8 sheet, we're gonna get two sides, and then the middle is just scrap.
So basically, Partel's just gonna cut out this line, and we're gonna hope for a good transition.
So all you need for a really good transition, Sharpie and cardboard.
Four. Mm. Studs.
See, I'm putting the screws in too much, so I stripped a couple of the heads out.
So we got the majority of both of the skeletons built. We have two more supports to add onto each frame. These two supports are going to be what's underneath and behind the coping. One thing for sure, from riding a scooter for so long, the coping support on a quarter pipe is super important, because the worst thing ever is to do all the work to get a ramp together and then the coping feels off. It's the number one thing people glance over, don't think too much about, and it's the biggest impact on how the ramp is going to ride, is how much that coping sits out and how strong it is.
So these guys have been working on the base and the framing for it. They got it pretty much done. They're looking pretty good. They're pretty tall. Yeah, they're looking pretty good. I mean, once they get this coping set in there and get the framing right for that, then we add the top layer of plywood and then the skate light on top of that, none of these things will be ready to ride. So we're a lot closer to the end than we are the beginning.
In place. We moved all the other extra wood right here. That's going to make it real easy when we go through the rest of it. We'll have a nice work area right here, because as you saw, we kind of had to move things all around because we had a bunch of stuff in this corner, and then that's where we needed the work. So now the warehouse is kind of set up properly and a little bit more of how it's going to be when we're all done. We'll finish those up another day. That'll clear out this middle here, and then everything else is all on wheels, and we'll be able to rearrange all that, redo our storage, redo the used apartment store. Yeah, I'm excited. Have the top layer down, then we gotta cut the skate light. This piece is already pre-cut. We just picked up the sheet metal. Derek's finishing up countersinking all the holes on top of the sheet metal. Once he's done with that, we'll be able to screw this down here. Get this last piece of sheet skate light up on this quarter. I'm gonna cut this to size, then we'll screw it all down. We're gonna be riding soon. So the last piece, the second layer of the plywood for the top, it's not lining up perfectly because not everything is fully square. So we have a half inch gap to close. So I got this jigged up to cut a half inch off of the top and nothing off the bottom. So we'll cut this at a little bit of an angle, and then it should fit in there nice and perfect. Alrighty, so we peeled the middle panels back up because we were having an issue where, because we didn't design this as an actual
half pipe. We designed it as two individual quarters. Nothing's holding the middle section down to the ground. So shy of doing masonry anchors, we're going to kind of just make some brackets to keep this plywood suctioned down to the ground here. So I'm gonna go through, cut the sheet metal up, and then I'm gonna countersink it so it can all sit flush, and then kind of just slide it underneath so that it'll hold the plywood down.
So all we gotta do, we got the coping in place, we got the sheet metal down, we just got our measurements to cut the two sheets of skate light. That one's rideable, this one's almost done. So we're just going through, I'm countersinking all these because I'm gonna have the plates sitting on the bottom like this, and then I'm gonna screw them down and then flip this upside down, and then this little skirt right here, it'll be secured down to this piece, and then it'll suck under there, and then that way that plywood won't come up at all. It'll just stay tucked under it so we can get the curve that we need since we didn't frame into the ground. Pretty much done. Just gotta put the coping back when the paint is fully dry, but this thing is all ready to shred. Got to do a little strip paint right there. We got all this painted. I'll add the coping there, add the coping there, add the coping there. I got a strap again once the paint is dry. I got a little strap to put that up against the wall. Now we'll be all set, build a little bit more, another little deck to stand on eventually with this extra wood, get this out of the way. Hope you guys enjoyed watching us build this thing, taking the one apart, building this new ramp here. So yeah, make sure to like, subscribe, follow for more.